Fact number one. Top frustration cited by over 59% of consumers is having to repeat themselves to different people. Customers' largest frustration is needing to repeat themselves to different people. As an example, when calling up a service provider and painfully spelling out all of the details, only to have to do it all again when you get transferred to a different department. Also, nearly 40% of users complained that there were too few options available to contact a business. Customers expect to contact businesses on the same channels as they use socially, so voice, video, message, and chat, at times that suit them, not the business. 30% of users also get frustrated by having to toggle between apps. So for example, I've got my healthcare provider and I connect onto the app to check the policy. Should I then want to contact the provider about this policy, I need to make a phone call and lose all of that context. When adding channels, communication APIs allow you to create an omni-channel experience, but allowing you to keep all of these channels within the app. And the most important element is that each channel is aware of each other, keeping context. Fact two, video minutes in EMEA increased by over 500% in April 2020 compared to February 2020. The impact of the global pandemic can be seen on Vonage's own data. In EMEA alone, the video API minutes grew at an astonishing rate. And while that rate of growth slowed down a bit during the year, between July and February, there was an over 400% increase. Overnight, the pandemic transformed the way we use video from a secondary choice of interaction to a primary one, where people can keep that personal connection while keeping a social distance. The ease of clicking on the video icon and being able to get in contact with your family over a WhatsApp group or joining a global audience for the presentation of the latest consumer technology was available before COVID. But video channel moved from a nice to have to a need to have. Fact number three, 55% of consumers have used video to connect with businesses and service providers, up from only 44% prior to 2020. Video in our personal and business lives was ubiquitous even before the pandemic. But our consumers are saying, and our insights show, that consumer-facing service providers have seen a massive increase of video usage. Now, Vonage Communication APIs allows businesses to easily and quickly add video into their platforms alongside other functionality like messaging, voice, notification, and even verification. Now, does that mean that all service providers should be adding video to all of their customer touchpoints? Not necessarily, but it's important to identify those interactions where video, readily available as a service, can be added to enhance the customer experience. Fact number four, top industries for video engagement post 2020 are, in third place, banking with 16%, second place, healthcare, 25%, and first place, education with 42%. The pandemic has accelerated and sometimes torn apart technical development roadmaps. Overnight, developers needed to replicate personal connections that could only be done seeing and interacting with others. Businesses, companies suddenly needed to adapt to a vastly different new normal where physical one-on-one meetings through to large group events could no longer take place. So whilst rightfully all the praise went to health workers and scientists who worked so hard to keep us healthy, I think we should also extend a big congratulations to all of the developers who innovated at record speed. They ensured that the industries we rely on could continue offering services to those who needed them.